All right. So yesterday we received our payment from Great Restaurant, okay? And we completed the journal, subsidiary ledger, and etc. So we've completed this journal out. So last but not least, we also received another check from Miss Katie. So here we have it right here. Receive payment from Katie's Coffee Corner for invoice number 106, check number 455. So, what are we going to do here?
All that same.
Anybody?
I'll take it. Okay, so we received a payment from Kathy's Cafe Corner. So just like yesterday, first I'm gonna go into our customer, our subsidiary ledger, and see how much she owes us.
Okay. So here we are, customers. Katie should be the second one, right?
So, let's see how much Katie owes us. So for invoice 104,
106.
106, I'm looking at the one above. Sorry. She owes us. So this is my computer's acting weird today.
No worries. Take your time.
Okay. All right. So on the 24th, we delivered her the coffee. The invoice is 106. We gave her the terms. And she needs the terms to get the 1% off of 15 days. Does
Good.
she? Yes.
Yes.
And then sales was for $265.43. So if we need. So I'm gonna start off with going back to the general journal. All right, so it's gonna be checking sales discount. Accounts receivable. So, just give her 1%. First, I'm gonna figure out the discount she gets.
Okay, so back to the subsidiary ledger.
So it's gonna be the $265.43 minus $30 of delivery.
Okay.
So one. Get it correct. And is it $2.35?
$2.35, yes. So she got a whole free pound of coffee.
Oh, awesome. Look at it that way.
Awesome.
Hey, I like coffee.
All right. So how much is she, is she subject to pay us?
$267.78.
67? Let's try that again.
I did not minus it.
Oh, I see. You added it.
Yep, I added it.
Okay.
I fixed my formula on my screen. All right, $2.63.08.
$2.63.08. Okay. Since we're here, should we just go ahead and fill in everything? Okay.
9/6/29, payments invoice. I they don't put the invoice with the invoices. 106 and check number 455. General journal 20. Just sales discount and payment.
How much does Katie owe us now?
Nothing.
She owes us nothing.
So we know check, and we got a check for the $2.63.08. Sales discount. Only $2.35. And the account table.
Mm-hmm.
Is $265.43. And then Kathy's Cafe at corner put invoice 106, checking 455. That we're going to go to our deposits. Deposit the $265.08. 6/29.
We're not going to do it yet because we still have the store sales.
I think, but different date now. Oh, yeah, yeah, okay.
No, we're on the same day.
We're on the same day. Yeah, yeah, I'm sorry. I just always put the dates on that for some reason. Now to our general ledger. Thank you. $26.29. Invoice 106. Payment. Now write check number 455. General Journal 20. And a credit for $263.08.
You said this was under checking?
Yes. Which brings the running total to $1,960.10.
What was that number?
Oh, you know what? Did I go to the wrong check? I went accounts receivable again. Sorry. Okay. Be $7,374.91.
Okay.
Now, over to sales and discounts. Invoice 106. 1% discount. General Journal 20. For the $2.35. Which brings the running total to 1887.2.
Good.
Now we go to accounts receivable. $629. Invoice 106, payment check number 455, General Journal 20, a credit for $263.08. Which makes this total $1,960.10.
He said 263.08. Shouldn't it be 265.3?
Oh, I'm not sure. Did I mess up?
You're on accounts receivable?
Oh, yes, sorry. Thank you.
You're welcome.
$19.57.75.
Yes.
Let me check. Did we? No, we paid him the commission already when he delivered it.
Mm-hmm.
So we're good on that. So I think we're all done with this transaction.
Yep, we already did the subsidiary ledger. Right. And yes, we are good to go with this one. So then, what has happened next?
A payment from Super A Market for invoice 103.
And?
And 107.
So they paid for two invoices with one check.
the total is that they owe? And their customers? So 103, they met the terms, right?
103, yes.
So it would be the $498.80 minus the discount of 1%?
You wouldn't minus the discount.
Or I would add it.
No.
Get the total.
You would not add the discount. How do I get the discount?
By finding the 1% of the 498.
What does 498 include?
You got to minus the delivery charge.
We have to yes, you cannot take a discount off of the delivery charge. So here on the side, let's go ahead and do our side here so we know how much the discount is for both of them, because we're going to have to add them together, because 103 gets a discount, but 107 also gets a discount. So in this case, 498 minus the $30 for the freight gives you $468.80, all right? So what is going to be my 1% discount here?
$4.69.
Good.
Okay. And then we would figure out invoice number 107. So it would be the 920.35 minus the 460.18.
No.
Minus the delivery?
Minus the delivery, yes.
Minus the 30. Which is 830 or 890.35.
Okay.
And then that just now. Is
$8.90. Okay. So
would I minus the advance pay?
No, because this case it's the discount off the whole entire sale.
Okay, so now I would find out the total discount, total, the price with the discount now?
What do you mean by that? What total price are you looking at?
I don't know. I think I'm stuck right here.
Okay, so right now, how much does Super A owe us between invoice number 103 and 106? How much do they owe us in grand total?
$958.97.
Right. $958.57, right?
$97.
Okay. If I take a 1% discount off my first one, which was for $4.69. And I also calculated my 1% discount for invoice number 107. So what's my total discount here?
$13.59.
Okay, total discount, $4.69 plus $8.90 gives you $13.59, okay? How much do they owe me in grand total right now? If we know that they owe me a total, that's how much they owe me now. Yes, so 95338 will go under payment to get to zero. Yes, so they paid us a check worth $945.38, and we took a discount of $13.59 because they paid within terms. Good job.
Then we would go to the journal.
Journal.
629, and then checking sales discount.
Okay.
And accounts receivable. Checking would be for the $958.97?
$958.97, no. How much did they pay us?
$945.38?
Correct. Right? And then how much do they owe us?
$958?
Yes.
$958.97.
Yes.
Okay. And then for the note, Super A Market payment. For invoice number 103 and 107. With the 1% discount.
Oh, I forgot to mention that in the top one, but yes, it's good. Super A Market invoice number 103, 107.
And then check number 582. And then go to deposit.
I was going to do disc for sure.
General ledger.
Mm-hmm.
To assets and checking. Invoice number 103 and 107 payment. Check number 582. General Journal 20. For the debit of 945.38. For a total of 83.20.29.
Mm-hmm.
And then to revenue, sales, and discount. $629. Invoice 103 and 107. % discount. General Journal 20, 1359, for a running balance of $1,979.
Good.
And then back to assets to accounts receivable. Check number 182, General Journal 20, for credit of 958.97, for a running balance of
998.78. Good.
And that's it.
We need to finish the subsidiary ledger.
582 invoice. Would we put the invoice 103 and 107 or?
You could put it in, you don't have to put in the notes, you could put it in the invoice section.
Yeah. Reference, general journal 20. And that's it?
Mm-hmm. All right, good. So then what happened next?
Submits an order for a great restaurant.
Okay, so what do we do here?
Okay, so what I want to do is I want to go to, the subsidiary ledger. So I want to go into commissions. Customer, great restaurant, and then 56403 is the sales amount. Should come to 5640 on 10%.
We didn't sell it yet, so.
Oh no, I didn't do the total commissions. Like I just. I bring the percentage down, but I don't do the running balance. I do the running balance on the right.
Okay. So 56403. Got it. Okay, so I guess Excel calculated for me.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, that's the way I have mine set up, but on the total commissions, it only goes in if I pull it down each time, like when after he delivers, I go in, I pull it down, and that brings his commission over, like, and it gives me the running balance for the second pay period.
Okay.
And that's all we have to do for that one.
So then, here we have it, daily sales.
All right, so we're gonna copy and paste from above, checking sales for medium, sales large, sales medium supreme, sales large supreme, sales ceramic coffee mugs, sales tax payable, in-store sales notes again, and then cost of goods, regular, cost of goods supreme, regular coffee, green coffee.
Oh no, I forgot to copy the numbers. Let me just go back up real quick and then we'll go. Okay.
Boom, boom, boom. All right. Starting off with checking. $2,861.41. Okay. sales, sales, medium coffee. $497.50. sells large coffee, 672.75. Sells Supreme Coffee Medium, 620.01. Large Supreme Coffee, 802.70. Ceramic mugs for 55.92. And sells tax payable 218.53. First things first, go over to my deposit.
Can you give me 1 second?
I'm going to go to deposits. I'm going to deposit the $2,867.41. Knowing we're at the end of the day, I add them all up. All our checks that came in today, and get a total of $4,626.66.
$46.26.66. Good.
Not a bad day at all.
Mm-mm.
All right. Everybody's caught up. We're going to go ahead to our general ledger. Okay, 629 in store sales. General Journal 20. A debit for $2,867.41, which brings our running balance to $11,187.70.
$11,187.70?
Yes. After that, to our revenue. 629. We sold 250 cups.
Wait, hold on. 250?
Yes.
Okay.
General Journal 20. A credit of $4.97.50. Which brings the current running balance to $4,774.01. Down to sales regular large. 629. We sold 225 cups. General Journal 20. For $6.72.75, brings the balance to $5,935.15.
Which one are you on right now?
Sales regular large. Large regular coffee, sorry. Mm-hmm. And sells medium supreme coffee. $6.29. We sold 249 cups. General Journal 20. For $620.01. Which brings the total to $6,058.17. From here, we're going to go sales large supreme coffee. $6.29. We sold 230 cups. General Journal 20. A credit of 802.7. I mean 70 cents. And the balance should be $6,857.85.
Okay. 68.57. 85.
We're going to scroll up to mugs. Okay, 629. We sold 8 cups. My fault. General Journal 20 for $55.92, which brings us to $1,639.12.
$16.39.12.
Yes. Down to liabilities, sales tax payable. $6.29 in store sales. $6.29 for $218.53, which brings our current running balance that we owe Uncle Sam to $1,855.12. If we go back, we know we used 40 regular coffee, 40 pounds and a half. And then, so I'm jumping over to inventory. So 629, we use 40 and a half pounds at a cost of 1.66295, which brought our total to 67.35. Our quantity, we're going to take the 178 and a quarter minus the 40 and a half, which gives us 137.75. Total on hand, cost on hand, 296.42 minus the 67.35, which brings us to 229.07, which brings our average cost for goods at 1.66294. And you gotta remember 67.5. Okay. Supreme. So Supreme, we had 629, we used 41.5 pounds at $1.89. Brings us to 78.44.
What's the total you got?
78.44.
Okay.
So we're going to take away the 41 and a half pounds from the 98 and a quarter, which is 56.75, and subtract our 78.44 from the 185.69, so this gives us 107.25.
Oh, yep. It. Yep. It's because of the half of a penny. Okay. Or in this case, it's 3/4 of a penny. So this should be 107.25.
So we had the that plus other what we have on hand, that 238. We get 376. 346.
Yeah, 346.
Okay, we'll check on it later when we come back. Now back to our general journal. Cost of goods, regular coffee is going to be $67.35. Cost of goods, supreme coffee is going to be $78.44. Onto our ledger, cost of goods. $6.29. We use 40.5 pounds. General Journal. $67.35. Which brings our running total to $11.99.43.
$11.99.43.
Yes. Then our cost of goods sold. Supreme coffee. Date 6/29. We use 41.5 pounds. General Journal 20 for $78.44. Which brings us to $1,276.25. Now on to our assets for.
Can you give me a second?
Assets, regular coffee. $6.29. We use 40.5 pounds. General Journal 20. A credit for 67.35, which should give us a correct if you balance right. $229.07, and yes, we match.
$229.07.
Our Supreme Coffee. $6.29. We used 41.5 pounds. General Journal. 20. A credit of $78.44. Which brings our running current balance to $3.46.00, and I think that's correct. Then we get to go home and sleep, and wake up in the morning and do it again.
Good. So here we're just going to draw a line just in case, and we're going to start off our new journal. So we're gonna start on journal number 21. Okay, and it's now a new day, June 30th.
I'll take this one. This one's easy. So we ordered some more coffee, so we're just gonna go to our POs.
Who are we ordering from?
Atlas Coffee Imports. 400 pounds of coffee. On my notes, I put 50-50. So I know 50% regular, 50% supreme. For a cost of $628. That is it.
Can you give me a second? I think my heels look different than yours. Okay, I'm good.
So next we delivered the Super A Market. Invoice number 110 with terms 1%, 10 net 20. So I did a copy and paste of accounts receivable, sales regular coffee, sales supreme coffee, sales ceramic coffee mugs, delivery income.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I did paste and copy for the cost of goods also. Accounts receivable will be a debit for $533.17. Sales regular coffee $213.85. Supreme coffee is $199.50. 89.82. And $30 for the delivery. The note is Super A Market. Invoice 110. 1% 10 net 20. Next, we'll go to assets, accounts receivable. Date is 6/30. Number 110, GJ21, for a debit of $533.17, brings the balance to $153,193.
$153,193.
Go back. I have 153,193. I'm not sure. Oh, that's because I forgot that this is. I made a 2-cent error, and I've been going back and forth fixing it. So thank you. I just found my other error.
Okay.
Now it should be 1531.95. From there, we'll go to sales, regular coffee. Medium regular coffee. $225 cups sold.
Okay, we're selling regular pounds of coffee.
Oh, wait a minute, that's right. Let me go down. My bad. Oh, I went down too far. Okay. Sold 65 pounds, invoice 110.
What did I write? 65 pounds.
GJ21. Credit of $213.85. see if I get this right, $1,394.96.
$1,394.96.
Good. Okay, 50% error.
96?
96, yes.
Okay, got it.
Okay.
Date 6:30. Sold 50 pounds. Invoice 110. Wait, hold on. Pounds, I'm sorry.
That's fine. You're doing fine.
Okay. GJ21 and a credit for $199.50. Should bring that to $1,436.40.
$1,436.40.
Then we're gonna go to Ceramic Coffee Mugs. $6.30. Sold 18 mugs. GJ21. $89.82. That should be $1,728.94.
Try that again.
I've got so many numbers fat fingered here. I changed that one. Now this one.
Was it 92 or 82? This is 89. Okay.
89, 82.
I have a different number too.
89, 82.
Yes.
I have 17, 28, 94.
Oh. Yes, yes.
Okay. I thought I did it again.
Okay.
Then we'll have to go to delivery and come after that.
Yes, we do. So delivery income.
It's down at almost the bottom. $6.30, invoice $110. GJ21, credit at 30, to bring the balance to 300. We'll go to the subsidiary ledger. Super A Market. Oh, good. Okay. Date 6:30. Invoice 110, GJ21, terms are 1%, 10 net 20, give you a discount date of 2 July and a due date of 20 July.
I still got 10 July.
10? Let me check my date. 30 June. Yeah, yeah, 2 July is not right.
Plus 10.
Anyways, I can fix that. Sales 533.17, which should show a balance for 533.17.
Yes.
Have to go to our commissions to give Albert his cut. So 6:30 for Super A Market. Put the invoice 110 in. And then that should give his running balance for this pay period of 271.77.
271. I got 271.78.
I see as I go up, I'm off a penny. Hold on, 1941, 2654, 9204. Why'd that come up 5859?
This whole column's rounded, right?
The 10% column? Mm-hmm. Yeah, I have equal rounded it. And I got no idea why I did that. Wait a minute, 585, 80, oh. Okay. 271.78.
Yes.
I had a number fat fingered again.
Oh, no worries.
Over everything. It makes no sense because my unadjusted trial balance is even. But every time I go, it's always like an even $2 that I have to go and switch around the counts. So, I mean, I get how it can still come out even, but this will be the third time I'm going to have to go redo my figures.
All right. At least in class, we'll be able to see and re-look at our numbers again.
And we still have to go update our inventory.
Yes. So here we sold 65 and 50.
£635. The cost per item will be 1.66294, which should give you 108.09. And you'll go over and update your inventory. Take the 65 from the 137.75, should give you 72.75. 229.07 minus the 108.09 should give you 120.98 for a new cost per item of 1.66296. Is good, we can move to Supreme Coffee. It'll be 6:30, 50 pounds at 1.89 to give you a cost of 94.50 or a total of 94.50. update that inventory. When you remove the 50, it should give you 675. Which, yeah, 12.7575. Back to our general journal. Plug these numbers under our cost of goods.
What was the cost per pound on that one?
The Supreme Coffee?
Yeah.
189.
But for the inventory on them?
It's 189. Remember, this is FIFO, so you have to keep them separate each batch.
So for regular coffee, it'll be 108.09 and 94.50 for the Supreme. So everyone's caught up, we can go back to the general ledger.
I just need to get my notes real quick. Mm-hmm.
Okay.
And then to where?
The general ledger, under cost of goods sold for regular coffee. Thirty sold 65 pounds. GJ 21. 108.09 should bring the balance to 1307.52.
Everything okay, Nicole?
Yeah, I'm good now.
You sold 50 pounds. J21 for $94.50. Brings that balance to $1,370.75.
I'm good.
Now we'll go over to the assets, to the regular coffee. $6.30, sold 65 pounds. J21 for a credit of 108.09. Should bring that to 120.98. And we do match.
So, can you wait a second?
Mm-hmm.
1265 pounds for the 108.09.
Okay.
If it's clean coffee, 6:30, sold 50 pounds. GJ21 for $94.50. 250-150 now. And I think I've corrected all my mistakes.
All right. So we're going to stop here, and when we come back, we'll just finish off the rest for the week 5 and do the unadjusted trial balance. So right now, it is... Exactly.